One story that the corporate media completely missed was that Fox News agreed to settle sexual harassment claims against both Bill O'Reilly and new Fox president Jack Abernathy. The suit was filed by a former Fox News personality named Juliette Huddy, who had alleged that O'Reilly began harassing her during her time as a co-presenter on his show, and that she was promptly fired after she refused his advances. What we know about the story so far is not very much, unfortunately. Yeah. We do not know the amount of the settlement. We do know from those involved that it was likely over six figures, which is good.
High six figures, I believe.
But we need to know what happened. And I'm sure there was probably some form of non-disclosure that all sides had to sign. But the thing that's so gross about this is the fact that this is not the first time that Bill O'Reilly has been hit with sexual harassment allegations. It's not the second time. This man is a predator still walking around the halls of Fox News. And, you know, based on his pattern of behavior, which is what a court would have used, this pattern of behavior shows that he is a threat to any woman working in Fox News. This goes beyond, you know, partisan politics and the horribleness that is Fox News. Clearly, there is an environment at this organization that is hostile and predatory towards women.
Absolutely. And one of the most frustrating aspects of this settlement is that neither O'Reilly nor Abernathy personally paid out any money to their victim. It was the, you know, the network covering their ass and covering the ass of their employees. You know, Bill O'Reilly is the most popular personality on the network, which is sad to say, but he is. So he's a big earner and they want to protect him at all costs. I mean, we went through the same thing whenever we learned about how he treated his wife and how he physically abused her and I think dragged her down the stairs and things like that and got
in
his
front
children
of the kids,
taken away. Yeah. It's clearly a really troubled, disturbed man who should be kept as far away from women in general as possible.
Well, and it is interesting the fact that, you know, if it happened, if you get one set of allegations against you and you beat those allegations or whatever and it never happens again, then okay, maybe those allegations weren't true.
Yeah.
I prefer to give the women the benefit of the doubt in this situation. There's too many times where they don't get that. But when you have a pattern develop, when you did it, you know, to one woman, and then another woman comes forward, and then the allegation or, you know, what you did to your wife, and then this one, there is a clear pattern. And again, it's not just O'Reilly who seems to have this hatred and, you know, a powerful sense over women. That's one of the reasons they do this is because they like to feel powerful. It's Abernathy. It was Ailes. It is this infection inside of Fox News that they cannot control themselves. They feel the need to do this. And, you know, it almost at this point, it goes on the shoulders of the people who actually watch Fox News. You're supporting this by watching the network.
Absolutely.
You're giving them viewership. You're giving them, you know, more numbers to sell for their advertisers. You're part of the problem. And I think people need to wake up for this. And that's one of the reasons this story is so, it's so disappointing that the media hasn't picked up on this.
Yeah.
In fact, when you consider the fact that, hell, your competitor just settled a sexual harassment suit. Oh, that's the only thing I'm talking about today. That's what CNN and MSNBC should have said. Like, you know, screw the nomination hearings for these guys. We can knock our competitor to the ground today. But instead, we're going to talk about nonsense and BS and let him get away with it and ignore the entire culture of manness and anti-womanness that is Fox News.
I mean, it's slightly encouraging because we've seen some shifts in the network. We've seen, you know, Megyn Kelly left, Greta Van Susteren left. They've jumped over to the previously liberal networks. That's not necessarily the best, but I think at least now there is a bit of an awareness, you know, raised about Fox's role and how they treat women. I mean, we've known even before these sexual harassment suits came out that there was a really kind of dark misogynistic vein in the network. You know, you have nothing but attractive blonde women in short skirts, you know, sitting alongside, you know, regular looking guys or whatever, you know, dumpy old guys, anything.
Yeah.
It's you have to be attractive and blonde to succeed on a network like that. So whenever you see such overt, what seems to be the more harmless forms of sexism and prejudice, you know, you kind of suspect that things like that are happening behind the scenes. And it's just, it's interesting and sad to see it confirmed.
When it also comes through in their coverage of events. I mean, Fox News is a network that if a woman gets raped, It's because she fucked up somewhere. Mm-hmm. She drank too much.
Yeah.
She was dressed a little too provocatively. You know, she was in the wrong place. She shouldn't have been there. Mm-hmm. She should have had a man with her to protect her. The misogyny comes through in the programming. Mm-hmm. I mean, that is how ingrained it is at this network. And, you know, I'm glad. I hope Juliet Huddy is happy with the settlement. And hopefully in time, maybe we will get the actual details.
Yeah.
Again, it's going to depend. We don't know what they signed. Non-disclosure is more than likely involved in this.
Yes,
otherwise,
absolutely.
It likely would have been leaked at this point. Mm-hmm. So,
yeah, I think the positive thing to come out of this is the fact that these women are able to pursue these cases, are able to come out with some sort of satisfaction, monetary, legal, or otherwise. You know, they're not being ignored. There may be some that are still being ignored and denied because of a lack of evidence, but more and more women, especially in notable positions, are able to speak out against the harassment and the sexism they're facing. And that's, you know, at least one positive thing out of this.